Paluyo sa ato ang kapihan sa Dipolo matag Domingo nga tanan. Uploaded kita sa YouTube. Click lang sa kapihan sa Dipolo sa YouTube. Naadihan ang tanan atong mga guests sa matag Domingo nga tanan. And then of course, live streaming kita www.rmdipolo.weebly.com. Pinaagi kang Silbert Adriatico Dondiano. Thank you so much. Of course, si atong mga live streamers, no? Nag-atang nato karon knowing ato bisita. Gauna pa mga diri atong bisita ganina, napasalamat kita kay dako nga nisanong siya sa atong invitasyon, no? Si Congressman Seth Frederick Bulit Halosos sa 1st District sa Zamboanga del Norte. Thank you so much, sir. Gauna pa siya diri sa ato ang mga kauban. So, kauban sa nato diri, si Taxi Lumba, nagdala sa ato ang tingog sa kahinginan. Simultaneous broadcast sa DXDR 981 AM o gingoman sa 94.1 IFM. Nanuka dito sa Barangay Turno ning Dakbayan sa Dipolo ang atong RMN Broadcast Center. Pinaagi sa atong station manager ng si Mr. Edgar Dagomo o gingon man na si Rochi Monera dito o si Mardi Libres atong mga kauban sa Radio Mindanao Network. Kini si Edith Pahintito mong inyong regular anchor and host sa Kapihan sa Dipolo katod kaninyo sa EPT Media Services. Ang Kapihan sa Dipolo katod kaninyo duha katakna nga tulumanon aron ihatag ninyo ang mga impormasyon may kalabot na sa kalambuan sa ato ang lalawigan sa Zamboanga del Norte. To God be all the glory. Thank you so much. O later on na lang nato pasalamatan ato mga commercials, no, ato mga sponsors na kay kining ato ang bisita, doon na po nila in pang appointment. So nagpasalamat gani kita nga nisanong siya sa atong imbitasyon kay ato kong pasalamatan da ay nga wala mag-brown out karon. Oh, kay thank you sa National Grid Corporation of the Philippines. Karon mo ta ang schedule nga brownout sa NGCP. And then nagkondisyon nako nga walay kapihan karon. Dayon nanawag man nato si Beth Ladaga, ang Regional Public Affairs Communications Officer sa NGCP, nga gi-reschedule to a later date ang supposedly brownout karong adlaw. So thank God for that. Naatay kapihan sa Dipolo ang very important kay ang ato ang bisita karong butaga, ang ato ang congressman sa 1st District sa lalawigan sa Zamboanga del Norte, Congressman Seth Frederick Bulit Halosos. We will go direct to the point. Unya na lang atong mga commercials, atong mga sponsors, no? Bisan og nagdala kini kinabuhi sa atong kapihan sa Dipolo. Later on atong lang i-acknowledge kay apiki kay ang panahon sa atong bisita karong butaga, kay balo ko nga daghan kay tang importante nga pagahisgutan karong buntaga. So first and foremost, mga kita og greetings alang sa atong mga tigkaminaw karong butaga, sa ato ang pinalangga nga congressman, none other than Congressman Bulit Halosos. Good morning, sir, and welcome back to Kapihan sa Dipolo.
Good morning, Edith. Maayong buntag sa atong mga tigpaminaw, no? And obviously, people all around the world, no, nagtanaw sa atong live streaming sa DXDR. Good morning, Ma'am Edith, no? Murag tayo lang na host karon. Oh. Mako-host ko. Mag-one-on-one, mayo. Oh, okay.
Willing discussion.
Yes. We were here early, no? In fact, that's how excited I am to be in this as a guest here in Kapihan. Kay murag dugay na gyud ko, no? I think the last time I was here was before elections,
yes.
No? And then yes, and I owe all to the people. I'm also aware of everyone's talking about the hearings and everything, and I need to explain to them, no? Kanang mga dili maka understand how is it going on sa role ana. Monang I presented myself this morning para mahatagan o mabigyan linaw, no, kining mga napanghitabo sa atong probinsya.
Okay, thank you so much, Congressman. Let's start the ball rolling.
Let's do it.
Okay, so before anything else, I have ato sa pinakahinam-hinam kay interesting topic about the congressional inquiry. Mautana lang tano para lang mahibawo po ang imo mga constituents sa 1st District sa Zamboanga del Norte. What have you done as a congressman there? Aside from the very famous congressional inquiry, your accomplishments in the 1st District of Zamboanga del Norte, public service.
Since I started or last year?
Last year lang, sir.
Okay. Well, so last year and this year, syempre we have continuing programs, continuing projects, no, in terms of infrastructure. Makukompleto na natin ang katong dugay na nato na project kanang Tourism Coastal Loop sa Rizal to Rizal.
Yes.
And invite everyone to go around, no? Suruy mo.
Nakasuruy ni dito.
Ay, guwapo sa'yo.
Panganuran, Dapit.
Yes, nice yes. Ah, panganuran so, dito sa naitindahan sa kapitan dito. Maayo kayo.
Guwapo kayang
Diyos. Guwapo kayo, no? That really helps, no? With the economic activities diha sa barangay, nahataga na sila og another avenue to for income, another avenue to earn, no? So that's what we're trying to ano to una to take care of our environment and to see and kami being a congressman what we do is we support now we open up the gates kanang mga national roads gi palaparon na nato taas na kayo and right now there are a lot of access points already to the different municipalities no in fact we are also opening up karong 2018 kanang Maria Cristina to Cebu Tad that is the shortest route no to Cebu Tad you don't even have to go through the highway so pagsulod nimo sa Maria Cristina
in
Dapitan City ay nako I think it's only around 20 minutes wala pa siguro mga 15 minutes pag naayos na yan that is very good news sa ato mga estudyante going to the topic of our students padala nato ang atong scholarship program I have almost 20 million na atong i-allocate ever since 2013, no? Tuloy-tuloy, I have 2,700 scholars as of the moment. And I have 52,000 household members sa atong Servicio Bilis na program that not only gives medical relief, kanang pagpunta nyo sa mga ospital, not just here in Dapitan City, in Zanorte, but all over the country. No, in fact, I'd like to not only promote, but I'd like to ask sa atong mga beneficiaries sa atong medical assistance, even yung taga Polanco, katong ay one person na nahatagan ko 1 million kapin, no, just for that. In fact, even Potot, si Potot Lapot also, no, I think around 400,000, 300,000 ang natabang nato under the program, no. Like I said, padayon nato atong mga programa, the infrastructure programs, tuloy-tuloy naman, no. We are now going to be preparing to already inaugurate kanang Dapdap Bridge sa Polanco. And I am very happy that the mayor is very cooperative. And hopefully soon, you know, we'll get to invite the secretary himself, former Congressman Mark Villar, as a guest and to do the honors of inaugurating that symbolic bridge in Polanco.
Apil ba diya na kong katong nalabay mo yung gabi padulong sa Mutia? Apil ba diya ang kanang road widening diya?
Yes.
Diya sa Polanco?
Yes.
Going to the bridge also? Kay yes. One lane man ron ang bridge diya? Now correct. Traffic diya, lights?
Correct. So, actually, lahat ng mga widening projects right now for national roads, project na to. No? It's a continuing project. Muna ako, I cannot monitor kung where it has already ended. Pero padayon, no? Padayon. And hopefully, by the end of my term, tanang mga main roads, and not hopefully, I am sure, and I have guaranteed, and I have promised in your show,
yeah.
No? I have promised, by the end of my term, tanang mga national roads diri sa atong probinsya or sa atong distrito, sementado na.
Wow,
yes,
good
yes.
To know, ha? Kalabi na, kanang padulong po sa Cebu Tad, di ba? O kanang
correct.
Padulong sa La Libertad.
Yes,
ang maot kayo ng dalan, di ha? Kaya ang karon ang so far, gabi iganin niya, anto sa Mutia, pulang po, pinian Mutia, kuha na, sementado na ang dalan. Very, very, kuha na,
gita. Yes, yes, all the way to Libay, no?
Ah.
Oh, to Libay and...
Libay, Cebu Tad.
Oo, oh, and Kalube. Kalube, padulong na diha. And if you notice, if you go to Libay, lapad na ang atong kalye dito, no? And managamit na sa atong mga constituents ang wide road. Hopefully, dili lang sa pagdadry ng mga maisan, no? I hope maghamit good nila sa
purpose.
But that's how effective that road is, not only for our travelers, but also for as a drying mechanism no, sa atong mga barangay.
Okay, so much for that. Kay preliminaries man to, nga may sayran usab sa atong mga constituents nimo sa First District sa Zamboanga del Norte, nga you're not sleeping on your job as a congressman. You are doing your best and you have already given so much projects
yes.
In your First District.
Yes.
When it comes to infrastructure, agriculture,
yes.
Social services, and all health services, and all those programs and plans.
Yes, alam niyo, Edith, before we started, no, I don't know if we can rewind to the very first time I was invited here.
Yes.
And I told I challenge the people to check kanang mga projects na ako, yung performance ko as a congressman ever since I started to now at this point, no? And I am proud to say, natanang, exactly what you just said, no? Even outside of my jurisdiction as a legislator, I think I have done, and I am confident, no? Na nakita nato not only infrastructure, I have social services, I have other programs in agriculture, health, and education na atong gitutukan. And ako, I challenge anyone to even question, not question, but to see how many graduates and how many people in the district na natapangan nato to because of the programs that we have already put in place ever since 2013, no? So ako nalipay lang ko, and I'd like to also take this opportunity, no, because ever since nahuman tong 2016 election, wala ko nakapasalamat. So I'd like to say thank you sa ato mga constituents na nagmamahal sa Primero Distrito, that even up to now the support and the trust and confidence of the people are still with me. And I will assure you na padayon pa nato ang atong mga programa, ang atong mga proyekto, and by the time my term ends, I'd like to leave a living legacy, no? Not only as a congressman, but alam nyo, Edith, no, we have two roles to play kaming mga congressman. Not only are we a congressman, a statesman, but we are also a representative of the people. And when I entered into politics, no, my dad, former Congressman Nonong Alosos, always used to ask me, you have to make a choice. Are you a congressman or are you a representative?
Yes.
No? A congressman goes to the Koto Congress to do privileged speeches, to pass on bills, you know, to be vocal in Congress, to be the voice. And a representative of the district is someone who would come home to bring the bacon, no? Sa ato mga tao, no? Kana mga proyekto sa nasyonal, na iulit nato, that is the role of a representative, no, representing the province. And I think I'm confident to say I've done just that, no. If you see, I've also passed in a bill, and we're still passing bills, no, and napasa na in sa first reading kanang reclassifying kanang mga redistricting, no, kay kat. It's very confusing, no? If you look at ever since natukot ang
DPWH,
okay, ang 3rd Engineering District. Oh, that's actually in my district. Muna naglibog yung mga tao ba? And it's been there ever since. And murag, what we did was not only did we reclassify, pero para it will avoid confusion sa atong mga nasyonal, no? Pag maghatag og mga projects ang DPWH, minsan kanang mga projects na ako mapunta sa second district mapunta sa akin because maglibog sila. So it's a small step, but it's still a national bill. And nalipay ko that it was also already passed, no, in second reading and in finality.
Okay, thank you so much. Kapi ka una, sir.
Sure.
And ako i-acknowledge ang atong mga sponsors para madali ta. Thank you so much nga to kang former Congressman Attorney Rosilio Armato Ibarinaga, Undersecretary sa National Anti-Poverty Commission. Thank you so much nga to ka Attorney Sinen Olvis Angeles, Vice Governor sa Zamboanga del Norte, o Presiding Officer sa Sangguniang Panalawigan, Zamboanga del Norte. Thank you so much nga to ka Attorney Julio C. Napikit, Presiding Officer Pro Tempore, Sangguniang Panalawigan, Zamboanga del Norte. Dagang salamat nga to sa Esalex Bar and Grill, na former Batchuyan ni Bitoy, anaanay mo tang sa Martinez Street, nindakbayan sa Dipolog, na maligya sa Lamian kayo ng mga balbakwa, basoy, barbecue pork o chicken o ingon man mga cold drinks. Libre ang V2K o ingon man ang wifi sa SLX Bar and Grill kung mo at tumutog mga on. Kauban sa inyong mga pamilya o mga barkada, anaanay mo tang sa Martinez Street, nindakbayan sa Dipolog, ipanag-iyahan ni Mr. and Mrs. Ray and YF Akas. Maka na ang SLX Bar and Grill. Thank you so much nga to ka Mr. Henry Pichonero, atong Labor Attaché 1 sa Department of Labor and Employment, Palo, Hong Kong. Salamat nga to kang Attorney Ronald C. Napikit, atong Lawyer and Notary Public City Councilor sa Dakbayan sa Dipolog. Thank you so much nga to sa kang Mr. Muhammad Hassan Adjo, atong Provincial Agrarian Reform Program Officer 2 sa Department of Agrarian Reform, Santa Isabel, Dipolog City. Nagkasalamat usab nga to sa Janus Marketing, nga ipanagiyahan ni Mr. Janus Yu, former Barangay Chairman o former City Councilor sa Dakbayan sa Dipolog, nga namaligya sa lain-lain nga mga spare parts sa inyong mga sakyanan, sama sa Isuzu, Mazda, Suzuki, Hyundai, pagbanta sa ubos lamang nga presyo, ang Chinese Marketing, anay mo tang sa Quezon Avenue, hinggap bayan sa Dipolog, matawag sa telephone number 212-1148. Daghang salamat nga to ka, Mrs. Milagros Agustin, sa Chicago, Illinois, USA, live streaming ta, no, na kita kita nila, pagingon na ni Roger William and Jennifer King sa Omagh County, Northern Ireland. Daghang salamat nga to sa kang counselor Alimarlo B. Dagpin at ang panelist Chris Capian Sripolog nga nagmasteral karong panahona, so he can't make it, and belated happy birthday nga to kang Konsihal Alimarlo Dagpin. O birthday ron ni Hope? Harapan? Ambot na mas Facebook. Oh, daghang salamat sa nga to kang Congresswoman Gloria Labad-Labad, Member House of Representatives sa 2nd District, Sambuanga del Norte. Daghang salamat, Congresswoman Gloria Labad-Labad. Lately lang na to kauban ni Beth Ladagas sa NGCP. Napasalamat kita sa NGCP kay wala gidayon ang brownout karong butaga, karong adlawa. Mao na nga kauban nato karon si Congressman Dolet Halosos. Ang NGCP, hapit na mahuman ang 138 KV line na sa lungsod sa Pinian, di ba? Kanang dako niya kayo nga project sa NGCP. Dako kayo ng kalambuan dere, labi na sa 1st District. Yes. Oh. So, daghang kayong salamat. O ingon man, nga to sa atong mga kato ka, Mayor Evan Hope Boyet Olvis, Municipal Mayor sa lungsod sa Pulangko. Daghang kayong salamat. Nga to kang Vice Mayor Alfredo Baitit, Presiding Officer, sa Gunayang Bayan sa lungsod sa Pulangko nga just recently ato pong himong bisita diri sa atong kapihan sa Dipolog. Daghang salamat nga to kang Engineer Gilbert Cruz sa Tetra Cement Incorporated nga ang proyekto na ang hinutang sa Lower Erasan lungsod sa Rojas sa Buanga del Norte. Daghang salamat nga to sa atong legal consultant si Attorney Cusincio Palpagan Jr. sa Onay Aguila ang Lawyers of Rodrigo Duterte Conlord, no? Panahon sa eleksyon. O ingon man, nga ito sa itong mga panelists na itong ipaabot o silang Julio Salaveria, thank you so much, si PA panelist atong sa Kapihan sa Dipolog, si Konsehal Ruben Ligorio, si Board Member Romilio Boyli, ingon man si Edgar Soronda, si Mr. Robert Pinsoy, si Alfonso Pons Roda sa Philippine Information Agency. Kinsay wala, matawag na ko Silver Tax. Wala, present tanaan mo na to. Okay, so balik kita sa atong bisita karong butaga, ang ato ang kinakusgan sa House of Representatives karong panahon nga very sensational, controversial and all those things, no? So atong panila, ang Kapihan sa Dipolog is a medium, is a forum wherein all voices can be heard, whether you are on the yellow side and the political spectrum, yellow, blue, red, white, or any colors, no? And all the religious organizations na atadere, tambok, niwang, bata, tigulang. Welcome tayo sa itong kapihan sa Dipolog. So, kita may medium, kita po'y forum dire. Nga mo ay mo pasabot sa itong mga katauhan, straight from the horse's mouth, ug unsa ang issues of the day. So, karong panahon na, naukyab man, matod pa nila akong, no? Don't shoot the messenger. I'm just the messenger, okay? So, karong panahon na, naukyab ang ato ang lalawigan sa Sambuanga del Norte, gumikan sa gipahigayon na congressional inquiry dito sa House of Representatives concerning the alleged illegal drug trade of Sambuanga del Norte. And this was tanang authored by ato ang Congressman Seth Frederick Bolit Halosos. So, duha na ka beses ang congressional inquiry na inyong napahimutan dito, no? Nakandak dito, Congressman. So, ang utana, what do we expect out of this congressional inquiry? Doon na pa ba na umaabot na third hearing or fourth hearing for that reason? Or kinsa po kayo pa ang inyong ipatawag? Kay human naman ang mga, I understand, human na siguro ang sa police, no? Sa authorities o katong inyong mga witnesses nga naa sa witness protection program. Kana sa una, Congressman, kay later on na ang uban na itong mga questions, please.
Okay, una-una, no? Going back to what you mentioned a while ago, manang salamat ko ninyo, no? Ma'am Edith. I've been very comfortable here sa imong show. And that's the reason why every time mo invite mo, when I'm here, I'd always come. No?
Thank you so
ever
much.
Since I started, murag wala gyoy political color kining yes. Atong what do you call this? This show, no?
Yes. Kapihan,
public affairs program, no? In
thank you so much for the trust and confidence,
Congressman. Okay.
Kaya sa una ra ba, first time ka diri, di ba kakabalo mo binisaya, di ba ingong kunin mo, nga binisaya. Nag-remind ko. Okay, sige Kong, go ahead please.
Walang nalipay ko, no? And I'd like to use this as a more platform, no? To air out kana mga other issues sa atong distrito, sa atong probinsya, and like you said kaniya, the controversial committee hearing. Like I said, that was not intended to be controversial. It just happened to be so.
Yes.
No, on the course of sa hearings, murag naano man ang ano, murag na buklat man, and that's the reason why right now, if we're going back to your question, okay, we can go deeper later. Ah. Ang pangutana nimo, in regards to the committee hearings after, no, we're already done with two committee hearings. And after that happened on Monday, tapos katong Wednesday, nag-break na ang Congress. No? So the last time I spoke to Chairman, he just said, now when we resume, pag-usapan nato if we're still gonna have another hearing. No? Kaya, well, medyo kompleto na eh. If you look at it, we already have enough to conduct our committee report. No? So, that is the end point of everything, no? Number one, to in aid of legislation to create a bill or a corresponding legislation na makatabang sa mga pagkukulang na atong mga kapulisan, mga ahensya, considering that we are also passing the budget of not only the PNP, the PDEA, the whole department, the LG. No, monang in order to do so, we have to see kung they are using this effectively, no? Kung non-performing or kung performing ba ang atong mga ahensya na nahatagan nato og pila ka bilyon na peso, no? That's why this is a very serious hearing in aid of legislation and to conduct a final committee report, no?
Okay.
Based on the first, the second hearing that we conducted. Like we said, it was started because of a resolution that I filed.
Okay.
Nakaduhan ako og privileged speeches in the plenary and murag nasanay na tayo magsalita sa plenaryo, no? I'm very happy that the House actually prioritized our resolution and heard it immediately. And I am a very active of the Committee on Dangerous Drugs. In fact, I was in Kapanduanes, no? To personally to inspect, to enter kanang controversial biggest shabu laboratory found here in our country, no? And just for everyone's ano, I think some of the people would think na ay political lang yan si Kong ana-ana, but what I'm just doing my role as an active member of the Committee on Dangerous Drugs. Manang even if dili nato ka probinsya and I'm not a representative from Catanduanes, it's also my duty as a congressman to do my job as a member of the committee hearing committees given at hand, no? Manang naabot ta sa Catanduanes. Good morning, Edgar. And so inana, no? Hopefully when we get back or when we resume, malibawan na nato if I padayon pa nato yung third hearing, or we will terminate the hearings already and come up with a committee report.
Okay, kayot lang ha, Gar. If panalit para dili mawala mi sa among discussion. If panalitan o mapadayon ang congressional hearing third time or fourth time, kinsa atong gi-expect na inyong ipatawag as resource speakers?
You know,
man naman ang mga pulis,
yes,
witnesses.
It's a very it's a very sensitive, no? It's a sensitive issue. Manang even kami mismo magbantay. Ako mismo magbantay because exactly the point wherein they are pushing that what I'm doing is political in nature.
Yes.
That's what I want to prove that it's not. Because if it was, I could have called the governor, Pinpin, or the mayor, or whoever of their family from the very start of our hearings, which I did not. This is the reason why, if you're going to ask me, there's another third hearing, which I don't also see the point what for. Everyone has spoken. The statements have been read, even the other camp, so they cannot say that it was unfair that we bullied them. We gave them the chance to air out or to bagon, no, ang mga pangutana through their lawyers. That's why I did not object when the lawyers were there. Although it was a house inquiry wherein you cannot invoke your right to stay quiet. It's because you also have the duty to, as a resource speaker, to talk. Maunang we agreed that even if the lawyers were there, magsalita kayo, and to present your affidavits, which they did. No, so I don't see another hearing. Kay kung ako pangutan na, no, I don't want to involve the governor here. I don't want to involve Pinpin Oy or the mayor. If you notice, you can go back to the hearings. It's on YouTube. I-check nimo. I did not mention the governor. If it wasn't mentioned by the Daligdig brothers. No, in fact, if you count how many times and who has mentioned the name of the family Uys, it wasn't me. It was even P.D. Wagan, everyone else, but me. No, I was very aware of that, and I was very careful not to bring out their name. Kasi syempre, it's unfair also for them, because they're not there to answer.
To, no? Defend themselves.
To defend themselves. So I did not. So going back to your question, if I should call them for the next hearing, I don't think so, because we are not a court, no. I think cases have been filed sa ombudsman, and we'll let the proper procedure you go, no. So wala ka lang nato, but the committee report na himuna mo will also help siguro with the investigation, also with the bills that we are preparing, no. Like you said, going back to that, no, the whole objective of the hearing was in aid of legislation. And if you guys ask me, what is the end point of the hearing?
Yes, what do you hope to achieve?
Exactly, no. We are preparing, my staff. In fact, right now I already have the draft for this bill. It's called, I'm sure you guys know that, no, Superior Respondiat Superior, Respondiat Superior. Which I think it's about time that we pass a bill putting in, let's say, kung officer ka of any, let's say, your governor, your a provincial director sa PNP, if you instruct one of your subordinates, people under you, no, and if you're in authority, and you ask them or you order them, no, you order them to do something illegal, mas mabigat yung kaso na ma-file sa officer in charge than the person who was only asked to commit it, no? We are talking about people in authority, no? So, murag mahimog aggravating circumstance yung mga, yung officer, no? So, okay, na, barato na. And kanang the subordinate who committed the crime or the order, no, would get a lesser sentence, and mahulog yan sa mitigating circumstances. So, makatabang na, no? I'm even in the police and the people sa ilalom, no, would be happy. And I've talked to a lot already, the PNP, the PDEA, and they're very happy na sana maipasa na yan. Because sometimes, they have to obey first, eh, before they ask. Inana man yung rule nila, no? Obey first, ask questions later. Kahit illegal yan. Kaya nga, no? Siyempre, sila man yung amo, sila man yung in authority. Who are they to question, no? Which is happening right now. So, ang bottom line and the bottom, at the end game of all these hearings is to create a bill, respondeat superior, no? Na magamit, no? Na ating mga kababayan, no? This is a national bill that will help our country. And makasigurado tayo na dili abusuhin ang mga posisyon na gihatag or na entrusted sa ato mga katawhan and appointed by our president sa mga officials nila, no?
Okay, thank you so much. Before we proceed, we would like to acknowledge the presence of Edgar Soranda and then later on si Alfonso Roda sa PIA.
Okay, thank you, salamat, and good morning. Labi na sa atong bisita karong buntaga na gabi na itong gipangandoy na mag-bisita gito itong Kapihan sa Dipolog. Thank you very much itong Guzman Bolt Filosos for greeting Kapihan sa Dipolog this Sunday. Balapang naghanggatan nga madungog si Congressman Boli Talosos Kalbuntaga. Kung sa itong mga suki di Panginoon, good morning. Sorry na late na kay gikan pata sa itong obligasyon matag Sunday. Niagya po pala niya punta sa itong Kapihan sa Dipolog. Stay where you are. Don't move the channel.
Okay, thank you so much. Si Pons Rada sa Philippine Information Agency, Pons.
Okay, nagsama tayo dagmayang buntag sa itong nasaking Japano sa Kapihan sa Dipolog. O sa itong bisita karong buntaga, madalag init tas pandesal ang personalidad. Tungod sa mga nagkonghitabo sa itong palibot at ang bisan tuman atong hangyon ng itong makaisunan, paminaw na tayong mga pangatagpunto sa argumento o kamunay bahalang mo timbang-timbang. Masab, bata, nadugay ta kaya tulig kahagahapon mamut kapahigayon niya sa among renewal sa among pagkalagat sa simbahan as kabag so nagtapos ng kapon din kanina may misa kanoniko o gipsugahan ko to ni Father Ramil Corong sa diha magod sa sekta sa kwan St. John Newman Parish 50 ni kaping ka mga kabag o doon na po'y daghanan ng magkatikista ni Dugan o dawat kang ina sa among bagong mandato isip kaabag sa itong pagtuong katoliko. Huwag ka itong sa itong mag-uubang congratulations sa itong mga tigpaminaw main butag.
Thank you so much, Pons. No? Congratulations ninyo tayo sa mga kaabag. Atong dugangan o dabo-dabo sa pangutana, si Congressman Bulit Palosos. Kong, speaking of politics, no? Imagin nato na makuan, no? Madinay, di po na to na ma-ignore na nga isyo nga daghan jud ang ingon nga pamulitika ra jud na no kay last term as a congressman maybe you are conditioning the minds of the people because you are planning to run as governor of the province of Zamboanga del Norte and 2 years is not far away, it's just around the corner, who knows, no? Pero kay wak makakabalugod unsay mahitabo sa umaabot. So congressman, right here, right now, your straight answer, please.
Okay, no, actually, right now, to be honest with you, no, mag-last term naman ko as congressman. I haven't or I don't have any plans yet as of this moment to run for any office. And when I say any office, whether or not here local or whatever office it is, alam niyo po, that's why when people always ask that it's political, atong gihimo, no, I think that's very unfair. It's very unfair because right now, bago lang tayo nakadaog, no? It has only been not even a year, no? Not even a year since we took possession. And even ako mismo, I don't think I'd like to carry this burden. Kay trabaho yun ni, no? This is work. This is additional work for me on top of the projects, on top of everything that I have to do in the district. You know, if you're a political tactician, if you're a strategist, this is actually the worst thing that you could do. No, to do something this early, you know why? Because there's so much time, no? And imagine if this happened maybe 2 years from now, then I could probably say that this could be political and there could be something behind it, but it's not my fault that these people came to me early on, and it's my prime duty and responsibility as their representative to expose something like this, because I am also part of the province. I'm not only a part of the province, I am the representative of the people in the first district. These things na napanghitabo sa atong probinsya, this attention of the officers kanang mga head secretary should be called, because it's been happening not only now. This is the reason why if you look back, no, I've been minority 2013, no, I've been part of the minority bloc. And even then, I've been very vocal. Even the time ni Maclang, I've been very vocal. You all know that. I spoke against the injustices that happened in our province long time ago. Why wasn't that called to be political? Why is it now that I am still doing the same thing that I've been doing ever since? Political na noon. No? I have not changed how I am. Look at me. I still... Murag dili pa ko murag congressman, no, because I'm not the conventional politician. I do what is right, and for me, as far as I'm concerned, what I'm doing is justice for the people who need it here in our province and in my district, no? So ako mismo, every time when people say it's political, I think it's unfair to judge what I'm doing to be political. Kaya ang ipangutana ninyo, no, like I said, it's convenient for people to say political lang move yan, when it's not even election anytime near. We just won. Diba? In fact, I want to relax and I want to enjoy my victory as a third termer congressman in the first district, no? And as much as I want to be in the district all the time, because of what has happened, I've been constantly in Manila trying to get answers and trying to help people. Kay basin magabaan ko if I don't do anything about it. You know, the people has given me the trust and confidence to fight for our district, and that's exactly what I'm doing. Para masigurado na dili maabuso ang distrito o ang probinsya sa mga tao na nakaupo or sa mga officers, no? I'm not pointing whoever it is, no? At least dili maabusar ang atong probinsya.
Okay, thank you so much, Kong. No? Speaking of faults, no, ako i-relate na karong bago na nawagan mangganing si Secretary Wanda Teo sa Department of Tourism na hinay-hinay lang daw ang media sa pagbalita labi na sa extrajudicial killing sa Pinindaw, allegedly, no, in the country today, kay nawala ang atong tourism industry, na minus atong tourism industry. Now, I would like to relate that question to you. Kaya ang Zamboanga del Norte is very much progressive. It's now very popular. It's a tourist destination. Daghan kayo mo arrive sa tuwa, kay peaceful place. Daghan po kayo ta mga tourist spots within the province. Karon, relating to that, ang panawagan ni Secretary Wanda Teo sa tourism, na murag, nabulabol bangod ang Zamboanga del Norte karon because of this congressional inquiry na gipanguluhan ni Congressman Ace Barbers, no, which ikaw po'y naka-emanate ani dito, naka-trigger dito sa ibang privilege speeches, no? So, along that line, Kong, how do we turn around the quote-unquote supposedly negative image na kuha karon sa probinsya sa Zamboanga del Norte because of these bad publicities emanating from that congressional inquiry?
You know, Edith, no, ako, I don't believe na what I'm doing is putting the province in bad light. Kinuod na very progressive ang atong probinsya. And I think you have to look at me when I and when you see me, I think, no, it's fair to say na kung kinsay pinaka-affected when it comes to negative image in terms of tourism sa atong probinsya, it will be our family, no? Because that's our bread and butter, which is tourism in the province. That's not my objective. And if you look into the facts, no, let's all go back to facts and evidences at hand, no? Is it my fault na during 2013, and no less than the AFP chief of staff wrote a letter investigating all the crimes happening here in the province against Maklang? Is it my doing wherein no less than our bishop wrote, all right, I think February 2015, wrote a pastoral letter, and this is public document, no, condoning mga heinous crimes that have been happening here in our province, no? So if you're going to ask me about EJK again, what we are doing is we're trying to shed light to what is happening in the province, and it's been happening for a very long time. Muna ako magpasalamat ko sa atong administration karon that it has given us more of a confidence to talk kay na hibawan nato na naminaw ang atong mga heads of lalo na ang atong presidente and ang atong mga secretary sa mga ahensya, and they are willing to investigate, no? And that's all I'm doing. I'm not going out in a flurry of interviews, in a flurry of ano mo nang, if you ask me, this is my second interview, no, the only, and it will remain that way. Dili ko ganahan magpa-interview, mainly because of that. I don't want it to look like grabe kaayo ang probinsya. I want to stick with the facts. I want to stick with the evidence at hand. Everything is public document. Sa tanang gipanggawas namo during the hearing, that is all public document, and that is all facts. No, mao nang they cannot say that I've been reinventing everything. Kini mga tao na gipatawag nato, it's fact that they work for the city government. It's not my fault that they're involved. In fact, no one denied that they didn't know these people. Mao nang ako, I want to bring that question back to them. No, they keep saying it's political, but if you look into everyone that was talking, they are their people. They were under the police, and the others were helping the police, and the others were even employed by the city government of Dipolog. So why is it is so convenient for them to say it's political, or for them to say gi-invento na ako? Na wala mang koy tao diha. That's all your people, no? All I'm doing is giving them the platform to speak and to ensure that justice be served. For once, no? Since 2013, our province has been abused, and we all know that. Kamo kabalo ana, no? It's not political, no? But I know deep inside. I want to ask you. Let me ask you again now. Let me put the question to you.
You are no? Our guest.
Yeah, no. Ma'am edit, no? I think the people should know. Let me ask you. Since 2010, no, since 2013, sige, sabihin natin 2010, do you believe that the province is safe? Do you believe that in the hands of Maklan, and right now with all the killings that have been happening, is that simple EJK? Then, for your personal opinion, with everything that I've laid out because of the hearing, let me ask you, as people who have their own opinions in their minds, no, to speak freely.
Yes, sir. To answer your question briefly, no, because I am not at the hot seat at the moment. You are the one. Dunay nang namatay. That's a fact.
Yes.
Okay. Pero as to who did it and what are the motives? Ito kabalo kay di man ta police, okay? So that's my short answer to your very difficult question.
Okay. I want the reason why I did the hearing was to have everyone involved.
Yes.
Everyone, no? Kana mga tao sa atong probinsya, sa atong distrito has the right to know what's happening and for me to expose it in a way wherein they can judge for themselves what is happening, kontinuod ba o dili, based on the facts at hand, based on the evidence that we presented, based on the statements of the people that we called to attend the hearing. Inala ka simple, no? That's why karon nalipay ko that the people can judge, no? A lot of people believe, some people don't. That's their opinion. Now, yes. Like I said, it's a free country, and I'd like, from now on, I'd like people to think on their own. No, dili ta magpadala sa issues, dili ta magpadala sa mga lideres or sa mga political leaders. Also me, I'm not saying that you listen to me, that what I'm saying is true. What I'm saying is based on the facts that we have presented, you have now you have the tools to decide kung tinuod ba or dili based on what's been happening in the province ever since. No, so if it's anything na I'm very proud of, I'm happy na at least I've exposed something that's been buried very deep inside, and that it has now been uncovered. No, for them to decide whether it's true or not, that's up to them.
Yes,
no?
Okay.
Not up to us.
So you are the politician, you are just the media having this interview. Okay, to set down and constraint. Okay. So ikaw ay politiko. How come nga silang daligdig itong mga witnesses nimo sa inquiry dito manidagan nimo? In what way sila, diun sa nila
pag-uulong nimo? Let me give you the sequence, no, okay, as to what happened. During the time I was in New York, I did a short course in Harvard. I've been accepted, no? I'd like to use that also. So I think in here, sa buong ano, in the history, I don't think we have a Harvard graduate. And I'm proud to be one.
Congratulations!
I'm very proud to be one, no? And during the time when I was in New York, this certain Maral contacted me and said that he would spill the beans and say, tell all, everything that has been happening in the province. Manang, this is very personal to me because I spoke to him.
Pero anang pagtawag niya ni Mr. Siamoy, nanawag ni mo, ikaw nawag niya, and nakaila ka niya kinsa
sila? Someone, yes, of course. Yes, okay. Kabalo ko, ana. He knows me and I know what's been happening. Yung nadakop siya, he wanted to tell everything. In fact, the only thing he requested wasn't money, wasn't anything. All he requested was for his safety. Na i-diretso siya sa witness protection program, which I assured him I would. I assured him, no? Na sige, pag balik na ako, I will bring you to the witness protection program where you can tell all. And kanang witness protection program, Edith, no, it's not that easy for you to get in. Okay, there is a very hard cross-examining that will be happening.
Background check.
Background check, cross-examination, considering that we are spending the funds of the national government. Tandaan mo, they will be forever under the Witness Protection Program. Their kids will be under scholarship. They will be paid by the government, no? Parang allowance or salary nila or something like that. In fact, up to now, and since they've been to the Witness Protection Program, I have no contact with them. I cannot call them. I don't know where they are. Dili sila, that's how, not secret, no? That's how sensitive, or that's how ano, the Witness Protection Program works. Ina anak mana, no? So, I told them, I told Maral, going back to that, no, that I would help them, assist him to seek help sa Witness Protection Program. But unfortunately, 2 days before I arrived, gipusil siya under the custody of the PDEA and under the custody of the Philippine National Police. This is not an ordinary tokhang, no? Because they have been in, they're already inside jail. Sama sa nahitabo ni Guiko. He was under custody and he was attending a hearing diha sa Bulwagan, no? So these things, it's very unusual, no? Unusual na nahitabo, and people have to be answerable to that, because if you are not safe even in the hands of the police, where you are already in custody of, where are we safe? Where do we seek shelter? Where do we ask help? If even our national police or our PDEA personnel, people who are in charge, I'm not accusing them of doing anything, but the inaction or the stuff that they did not do, which they are trained and to do, did not happen, no?
Okay, Edgar, yung pagtana, please.
Okay, tigang salamat. Mabalik ko gumay sa, good morning, Congressman.
Good morning.
Once again, sa Kapihan, sa Dipolog. Sir, you've been mentioning that this thing that you've done now is putting Sambuanga del Norte into the bad scene, matul panaw nila, maudin reaction nila. Tama, sir, you're from the Pitan, and the Pitan is known to be a regional tourism hub. And you have the Cutler, and we have the Pitan alone is a place where dakan mga ano. Since ba ini imong dihimo, sir, nakita ba nimo nga ni os-os ang presensya sa mga bisita coming to the Pitan? The Pitan is also part of Sambuanga del Norte. You are from, especially Dakak, ni os-os ba ang atong mga bisita nga nisulod sa maong mga lugar tungod kay ingon ali ang nahitabo sa Sambuanga del Norte? In ani di ay ang Sambuanga del Norte?
Well, you know what? Ano yan eh? That's a question of ano eh? Whether you look at a cup empty or full. Mura ginanak ba? Right now, the way I see it, the people who come here, and when we have investigations like this, mura, that can also give confidence, no, to the people that arrive, considering they know that these things, or the police are doing their job, or the people in authority or in position are investigating or are on top of the matter, even dili nila trabaho. No? Like ako, if you go to, let's just use the example of Maguindanao, no? Pagkabaluta na na yung mga daghang patay, like right now, almost 200, based on the pastoral letter of our bishop, Bishop Kaermare, there was almost 200 killings in 1 year, no? Malipay ba ka, knowing na ikaw mabisita sa probinsya, knowing that these 200 killings, walay investigation, walay movement, walay nahitabo sa mga kaso, malipay pa ka na? Or mas malipay ka knowing that there's someone on top looking into this and making sure that the police are doing their jobs in that certain province? Going back to Maguindanao, Panginana, mubisita ka ba sa usaka lugar na kabalo ka, that everyone is playing murag fiddle with our people, na murag may tago lang, na wala yung mugawas ng mga krimen? Would it make you feel safer? Or would it make you feel safer that even things like this would be exposed and that, you know, at the end of the day, they will be held responsible if they're not doing their jobs? No? Manang nahitabo sa lugar nato, sa Pilipinas, in our country. So not only, we can very well compare it to the issues that's happening in our country. No? Ang ato, right now, what's happening with our president, President Duterte, no? And everything she said. When I went to Harvard, I was asked by my classmates kung kining mga nahitabo, no? That was one of the issues. Why are we letting a crazy man, a lunatic, lead our country? When he talks, that's what they're saying, huh? when he talks about killings and everything, you know what I told them? You know why you don't understand? Because we are not speaking your language. He is not speaking your language. He is speaking the language of our people, which only we understand. Nga no? Inaalaman ang kultura na to. Diba? Kung bata ka, baby ka, mo sunod ba ka kung imong papa masuko na magsabi lang na, oh sige, stand in one corner. That's a Western type of punishment. Corporal punishment, ang ano na to, that's what works because that's what that's the culture that we've adopted ever since we were young. Sa mga panahon ninyo, sa panahon nako, it's always been like that. Mutuo lang ta kung magawas na ang chinelas. Mutuo lang ta kung magawas na ang silhog. No? Kung magawas na ang asin. Kung muluhog man ka. Diba? Na, inana. Exactly. That is not, that is something that the Western or the UN or the Europeans don't understand. It is the language of our people that he's speaking to. And it's not, he doesn't mean to sound, cover up what is happening in our country because it's happening, just like our province. It's for you to decide whether these things are true. What it's my job and my responsibility to expose it and to shed light on the issue itself. Dili na ta pwede na magtago sa mga napanghitabo diri sa atong probinsya o sa atong bansa. I cannot sit here and end my term knowing na kaning mga tao involved in the killings that have happened, all the 200 cases that have happened in the province, remain at large. If I ask them, what happened during the time ni Maral that they are under the custody of the police? That's how unsafe our province is. Na even though you are guarded by 5 to 7 heavily armed men, pwede pa rin mabaril ang tao? If those two suspects and those two witnesses, what I call them, no? Don't stand a chance against people guarding him heavily armed. What more are people? Na wala kahit tenidor na panlaban, no?
So, sir, you are saying in one way, no? Pasabot sa mga ay before ni Edgar na kuan kana na ang it's part of an EJK, no? Kay like imong giingon karon na si Maral under the custody of the PDIA police. And then, pero namatay under their care and hands and protection. So, murag part na siya sa EJK?
No.
How do we distinguish that one?
Because ang EJK siguro, no? If naglaban, maybe that could be part, if it's questionable that happened in their house. But if you're under the custody mismo of these people, that doesn't fall under EJK.
How do you call that?
I think that's a rub-out. That's a very clear rub-out. What when we presented during that time, nakadungog sila na daghang mga buto-buto, no? Let the people decide. Walay natamaan. Ang natamaan lang yung karga-karga nila sa ulo pa. After, no? Don't forget the fact, after he has mentioned in public, in the newspapers and the radio, that he would turn around and tell everything he knows to the witness, to DOG, under the Witness Protection Program. So like I said, we cannot also remove that as fact. No? Dili nato pwede sabihin na he was under the custody and he was just a suspect na gipusil. He was not a suspect anymore when he already said that he would tell everything. I think when he tells everything, yan na yung ano eh, that's a clear rub out na nahitapo. Very clear. And up to now, wala yung report. Wala yung report sa SOCO. Wala yung report sa PNP. I've been asking for that report ever since. Mao nang nagpatawag na
ako.
None.
Yeah, yung sa SOCO.
On the first hearing, we have requested. I told the chairman, I'd like to ask for the full report. I've been asking for the report ever since. And up to now, wala pa yung report. That's the reason why I had to do the hearing. And up till the second hearing, wala gihapong report. No, you tell me. What happened? Is that how long our justice system is?
Pwede na sir nga, dili mo hatag report nga, especially karon nga gipush ni President Duterte ang FOI.
No.
Public records man.
No, it's not. Ikaw daw mag-check kung naay ano. The NBI has been requesting for the report of the SOCO ever since. Up to now, walay report. Up to now. That's what we're doing. As a committee member, kamao na nagpahiring ta. To force them to produce. Because so far, no one is allowed to ask, and no one, up to now, wala pa yung report, gikan sa mga police. Someone should be responsible, and even that, the inaction, or the, what we call, the dereliction of duty of these police officers, kana si ang atong provincial director, and the police under the investigation, hantog karon wala pa yung report? Ano? Tapos karon siguro, ipag-aos ninyo, kay we already pushed you, tapos sabihin nyo sa akin, politika. I've been asking it for so long. Dapat dili na ako mag-hearing, Ana, if you just presented it when I requested. Up to now, nahuman na lang ang second hearing. Wala pa yung report sa SOCO. Now, it is public. Everyone is listening to us right now. Kamu mismo. Kamu. Kamu magusga. Kung if there is something fishy about everything. Exactly. Like I told Provincial Director Wagan, this is not a case of pickpocketing. This is not a case of robbery. This is a case of a heinous crime wherein someone was brutally murdered under your custody, under the custody of the PDEA and under the custody of the Philippine National Police, which they should be held accountable for. I don't know Wagan. Personally, I don't know him. I don't have any problems with him. Pero pag pangutan na nimo, no, kung okay ba siya as a provincial director, I beg to differ because right now, the inaction that he's doing as the head chief PNP right now, na wala pa report, wala pa action, someone should be responsible for that. Sino ang responsible? Ako. Ako na noon, na ako nag-request ng, ano, na to bring these people to DOJ and to bring these people to the Witness Protection Program. No? So let the people decide. No? Muna ako, I'm very happy and I'd always, like, I'd welcome, no, mga invitations like this for me and for the people to understand thoroughly what is happening in the province. And now they have. They're free to judge based on the facts, based on what happened during the first and second hearing. Muna, dili sila makaingon that we were bullying them because we weren't. They had the time to respond. They had their own statements prepared. They had even their lawyers right behind them. I did not even have a lawyer. I all I was doing was presenting everything and asking them to answer, which they couldn't. Kasalanan ko pa na wala sila nakatubag.
Okay. You don't look happy. Even you said a while ago you are happy. Si Edgar Yapautana.
Follow-up. This is sort of... Congressman, this is a sort of follow-up then sa first question ko. Ever since you started this, Congressman, have you received any threat to your life?
Yes. Yes, I have. I have. A lot of threats. And honestly, I don't care. I don't care. You can threat me all you want and threat me all you want, but I will keep on pushing what is right. And I don't want to be a hero, and I'm not saying that more dramatic na anything happens, I'll happily lay my life down. You know what? All I want is justice. All I want is justice. I have a daughter. I have family members. I don't want them to live in a province when the police aren't doing their duties. I don't want them to live in a province where these things can happen in broad daylight without anyone, without any investigation and anyone. Kaya no, why I ask wala? Is because only ang tubag ni Provincial Director Wagan during that time was because no one came or there was no witness. Would anyone accept that? Kung wala'y witness, you wouldn't move? You wouldn't investigate? It happened in broad daylight, ha? Kana nahitabo kay Guiko. And other killings that happened. Exactly. Yan nga yung ano na po. Why do we need a witness? That is your duty as the PN, the Philippine National Police, to conduct the investigation. Ngano ako, dili man ko police. Ngano, ngayon, nakaproduce ko mga witnesses, nakaproduce ko mga evidence, and documents, helping the investigation or whatever, if there was any, even, no? Ako, I can also say, I'm actually doing their job.
Okay, Edgar, yung pagkutana, please.
Okay, kini katong na-mention ni Congressman Borico, kini action of the PD regarding katong mga nakitabo. Siguro, at this time, Congressman, nakaabot na ni sa office ni Chief PNP.
Yes. Actually, Edgar, no? Kanang mga lihok na ako, I have sent to the office of the President, mm-hmm. to the office of the DLG, to the office of the PNP. I don't know what else, what other office na wala. Every move I make since I did the privilege speech, tanang mga documents, tanang mga letters na gipasa na ko, I passed. Para klaro, no? And para everyone should have a murag, ano ba, murag tracer what is happening in our province, no? So, I apologize if people have been hurt or they think that I'm no, character assassinating them. But I wouldn't do that if they weren't, their names weren't mentioned. I wouldn't do that if they weren't directly involved in some way by these Daligdig brothers and by these witnesses that came out, no? Wala man nato gitawag si governor, no? Even though because yung katong respeto na lang, and for me to avoid just that, to be political motivated.
Okay. Commercial to ni Edgar, ato itaong kong ang pangutana ni Congressman, no? It's not politically motivated. And yet, it creates it's not a ripple, but it creates something like kanang worries and apprehensions of the people living in Sabuanga del Norte, and especially so from abroad, nga daghan kayo na-react, maybe delivered violent reactions tanan, pero na-react yun sila nga, unsa rin ang Sabuanga del Norte, how come nga nahimo, na inani niya, nga naman nga naabot pa man ang congressional inquiry bahin o mga killings sa ana-ana, nga kining Sabuanga del Norte is a very peaceful province. Gani, daghan kayo mga national activities nga gitay.
Yes, babuhin.
Mga, oh yes, katukto ang mga
National Festival of Talents, the
regional meet. Dagan pang umaabot. Mabuni mga apprehension sa mga tao. So, all these things, unsa may mahitabo dayon. Pag human sa congressional inquiry, we'll just forget it. Or naapatay, nyaranin mo ito ba ko, naman sa commercial, kasi commercial ka.
Ato sa on, ato nang palilak sa makadali ang atong kongresista sa atong murang distrito, si Congressman Bolit Rosos, alang sa atong mga sponsors. Ato pa salamatan una ang Hotel Camilo One sa Dalang Generalina, nito nagpulihan sa Dipolog. Pag ang Sunburst Fried Chicken, yung nagpulihan sa atong kapiyan sa Dipolog. Do ang atong official venue, aniyan na kita sa second floor function room sa Hotel Camilo One. Yung atong tapuyan sa Dipolog. Ato sa pasalamat sa atong Vice Gobernador, Vice Gobernador Sinito Angelos, sa lalihigan sa Bongga del Norte, o presiding officer sa Gunihan Palalihigan. Salamat sa Subcom Board Member Julius Napikip, presiding officer sa Tempolis, sa Gunihan Panlalihigan. Pasalamat sa Asalex Bar and Grill, Kamayang Food Trip, ideal for family, barkadahan, outdoor, and gathering. Formerly Patsuya ni Bitoy. Tulali, ang lamian kayo na servisyo o magkapatagamta ng servisyo sa Usalex Bar and Grill. Matawag sa PLDT Line 9080338 o in masarap sa number 0926-126-8726. Ipag-iag lumala nyo sa Mrs. Wyatt Akasa. Paliyan sa kita sa ni City Councilor Junal Dudu Napikit, City Council sa Lakbayan sa Dipolog. Napalusap ka nato sa Mr. Henry Chanero, ang atong Labor Attaché sa Doli, sa Palo, Hong Kong. Napalusap ka nato ang atong Port Manager sa Philippine Ports Authority, PPA, Port Management Office, Lapitan Port, Barangay San Vicente, Lapitan City. Napalusap sa kita ni Mr. Muhammad Dasan Adjo, Barputu, Dar, Santa Isabel, Dipolog City. Ang Janus Marketing, alam sa mga spare parts sa Mazda, Hyundai, Suzuki, Kubanta, Janus Marketing. Ipanagila, ginamala ni Miputak Barangay Chairman Janus Yu, matawag sa telepon nato 212-1148. Napulusap ka nato si Mrs. Milagros Agustin sa Chicago, Illinois, ni Roger, si Mr. Roger William of Jennifer King sa Omaha County, Northern Ireland. Huwag yun sa nagpalunod ka na to, ang bago lang nag-birthday ni Tunatalbayang Adlaw, si City Councilor sa Dakbayan, sa Dapitan, Alimalo Dagpin. Nga nag-birthday o kwantod. Congrats God, Kunsyal. Kunsyal Alimano Latin Bulletin, happy birthday. May palinusap kita sa may kandidato ni Congresswoman Bruna Labad-Labad sa Kongreso na representar sa segundo distrito sa Lalawigan sa Buanga del Norte. Ang National Grid Corporation of the Philippines sa Taybalong na hapit na yun na fully operational ang 138 cable line transmission na maghatag bilang kalambuan sa enerhiya on sa atong lalawigan sa Bonga del Norte. Pahibalo, ikan sa iyong disipo, pinagyan na ni Ma'am Beth de la Daga. Ipalong sa kita ni board member Ronilo Lee, kapanilo sa kapihan sa Bupologa. Pag-iing masal, nagpalusad ka na to, si City Councilor Atty. Robin Ligurio, kapanilo susabi sa kapihan sa Bupologa. Nagpalusad ka na to, si Polanco Mayor Evan Hotbury Olvis sa lungsod sa Polanco, o ba na iyang busy mayor niya, si Vice Mayor Alfredo Baitita, sangguniang bayan presiding officer sa lungsod sa Polanco. Gipalinsad kita ni Engineer Gilbert Cruz sa Petra Cement Incorporated, Lower Erasan Ruas sa Bonga del Norte. Ang ato nga legal counsel, ato ni Crescencio Palpagan Jr. sa Kapihan sa Dipologa. Pagtibaya nga ito na ni Mr. Vicente Changson na kanunang naglantaw sa ato nga Kapihan sa Dipologa. Kung alas mga itong trabaho, hindi ay nindot kayo sa DAR, sa Bonga del Norte, monitoring and evaluation specialist, 30,000 yung good, simple. Dayon, walo ka mga community extension workers, contract service na 15 mil ang bulan. Special station, godod, salog, tapilisan, diyon, pustigo. Huwag yung masag, duha ka project support staff na tag 10 mil ang bulan. Pagkitayo lang si Ma'am Shani, Pakatang Jacinto sa ang PIO sa DAR sa Bonga del Norte. Nagagod sa inyong application sa Parto, kang Parto 2, Muhammad Dasan Adjo. Ingman, gitaloyan sa kita. Sa maayong kabubutol ng atong panag-uban sa kapihan sa Dipolog, dipalino sabi sa Metro Shopper sa Rizal Avenue o Metro Com dito na sa Lou Plaza Mall. Alam sa pagkina sa mga gadgets, practice, plastic, plastic, sa Banta, Metro Shopper sa Metro Com. Napulisad ka na to ang Celestial Maritime Review Center sa Dipolog City Institute of Technology kung DCIT. Celestial Maritime Review Center, daghanan na kapasal. Himos yung review diyan na sa Celestial Maritime Review Center sa DCIT. Ilimusal, napaliwag ka na ito ang atong kanhi congressman si Gubernur Distrito, kanhi din sa GRMSU College of Law, si kung karoon undersecretary sa National Anti-Poverty Commission kung NAPSI, si kanhi congressman Atty. Rosilio Matoy Balinada. Ato sa panilis kini sa kapihan sa Dipolog, apang tungo siyang kabisi, si Congressman Barinaga, Yusek Barinaga, talagang sarang itong makauban doon. Di pala yung sabi ka sa Ann Seafoods House sa Barangay Baran, itong nagpayan sa Dipolog, labing-labi ang Seafoods House sa nagpayan sa Dipolog. Ann Seafoods House, ipalagiyang dumala ni Atty. Clyde Naong. Ang Gloria D. Dapitan, ang lugar alang na sa inyong pagsurusuros di ba't pamilya, ang naakas nagpayan sa Dapitan, Gloria D. Dapitan, na ang Thea Cinema, Buhaka Thea Cinema, Cinema 1 o 2 na ang Thea Mall o ang Thea Grocery. Yung, nindot kayo. O yung sa Fantasyland. The Fantasyland, na doon ang mga bagong rides, dagang pamilya, na ay world class na presentation matang weekend sa Fantasyland laban sa mga bagong rides. Let the child out in you sa Fantasyland. O ang inato lang restaurant dito na sa Dapitan Aquamarine Park o Dampa alang sa Lamian na Seafoods dito sa Dapbayan sa Dapitan. Inato lang restaurant. Mao kato ang mga nagpaliw sa atong mga atong palagubang sa kapihan sa Dipolog, mabati live sa mga sibyanan sa RMN Dipolog na nakalod sa Batong Station, na unahan lang gamay sa Karaang Station, unahan sa Tamahan na yun, no? Sa Turno, ang atong bagong station sa DXDR RMN of 94.1 FM. O mas kusog pa ang pag. Katong nagpaminaw ni Karong, hindi pa sa mga tag-reaksyon kung unsa kakusog ilang nabati nga estasyon, mag-text lang mo sa mga contact numbers ng DXDR, may bawaan na mo unsa kaklaro, unsa kakusog na ang inyong nabati sa sibianan ng DXDR o 4.1. So, balik pa sa itong bisita karon, nagdunugtong itong bisita ng itong kongresista, representante sa Primero Distrito sa Lalawigan sa Bonga del Norte, Congressman Bulit Rosos. Balik kang edit, Bet.
Thank you so much, Edgar, sa ito ang mga commercials. And without them, we are nothing. So balik sa itong bisita, karong butaga, atong ipaungong ang pangutana, iyang tubagon, sige na siya reklamo, sige na reklamo, relax, relax, you're so excited, sige, o, tubaga ang pangutana, ang stage na, sige, guhaan ko.
Musulong po ako sa barangay, dugay na ko wala nagbisita ba, but,
yeah, sa Bonga del Norte, being a progressive province, and then, ang inquiry na hitabo murag na murag naka-damage kamay especially nga ang mga to sa abroad gusto po nga mo
actually no yes it's true the progressive yung probinsya it's true that taga there's plenty that we should be proud about but this is also fact
no, 200 people cases or more have died. No, heinous crimes have happened here in our province. What should we do? Should we just be quiet? Kanang letter, going back to that, kanang letter ng no less than the chief of staff of the AFP, 2013, wrote a letter to the NBI investigating our province. Imagine that, the topmost guy, AFP chief of staff, I think it was AFP General Bautista during his term, 2013. Look it up, it's public document, FOI. No, salamat kay Presidente na FOI. We can already request documents like that. Has requested the NBI to take a closer look and to investigate on the crimes that have been happening, human rights violations that has been happening here in our very own province. Is that something that we should also be proud of? No? Like, those are the things, no? Hindi po pwede na ito talikuran kanang mga inana na mga issues just because it doesn't look good. It looks even worse sa ato mga kababayan sa Chicago, sa ibang lugar, kung if they know that when they come back here, na ay mga inana na mga patay-patay, na inana na mga drugs, and no one has acted on it. No? How about the pastoral letter? Again, I keep repeating that because I'm basing this on fact. It wasn't my letter. I didn't tell Bishop to write. But he was condoning all the killings that had been happening. Tama na. Ikapoy na siya ba? Eh, nakita na niya na grabe yung napanghitabo and all the killings that have been happening in the province. No, not only in my district, kasi siya man ang bishop. No? But look into that, no? Even that pastoral letter. That's the reason why I think we just have to do our jobs. No? Ako, I'm doing my job as a representative and as a congressman. Same gihapon sa mga ahensya that is appointed to or in charge of our province. Dapat inanapod, no? The police, the PDEA, the NBI, and all the other corresponding agencies.
Okay. Kay pangutana gikan sa text message, no? Are there other provinces that the House Committee on Dangerous Drugs had subjected to a similar congressional hearing? If yes, what provinces? If no, why Zamboanga del Norte only? What triggered it? Has the committee seen a link between the drug trade in Zamboanga del Norte and the national drug trade?
Okay, let me answer that. Yes. Bit, no? Number one, sa pangutana, if there are any other provinces, being the member of committee on dangerous drugs, other than Zamboanga del Norte, subjected to an investigation or a legislative inquiry, ang tubag na ako diha, yes. In fact, in between, before we had our second hearing, I was in Catanduanes myself. I was there. We flew at 2 in the morning. Wala ko tulog. I was in Catanduanes where we investigated the governor. Lahit gani, buti nga, wala yung investigation diri sa atong probinsya because I wanted to avoid political backlash. I wanted to avoid it to be used for political reasons and to avoid the governor to be put in that light because it's not an investigation towards him or his family. It's an investigation on the drugs and the killings that has been happening in our province. No? So going back to that question, yes, we will have our next committee hearing sa House na. Gipatawag na mo ang governor, gipatawag na mo ang mga police, gipatawag na mo even the judge and the provincial prosecutor. Kay gisabunan ako, no? During that time, because when we went to Catanduanes, just to give you a brief description of what happened, we were barred from entering the said factory by no less than the governor. Can you imagine? The provincial prosecutor and the PNP, the provincial director of the PNP and the regional directors were there present. Murag, nanawag na mo, and we were already entering the premises. We were instructed to hold apparently, there was a call from the governor or from the provincial prosecutor disallowing us to enter the said premises, which we question. Sabi na mo na in 5 minutes, kung dili pa mo magano, we will enter already. And that's what we did. Pag enter na mo, gipatawag na mo yung judge, gipatawag na mo yung mga police, gipatawag na mo everyone in the mayors, were all present during our hearing sa Catanduanes. And now we are going to be bringing all of them to our next committee hearing in the House. And I think that's also uploaded already in YouTube. So I encourage, no, seeking sa any text, please look into that. And you will see that what I'm actually doing is far from what we did in Catanduanes. No?
Atong sa Catanduanes, sir, parehara na siya nga aid live streaming na sa YouTube.
Yes, yes.
And then, kay,
let me cut you lang, Vegeta. During that, yes, ang tubag ana, no. Because we did the hearing in the province.
Okay.
Although, I told the COMSEC, committee secretary, to upload upload the video to YouTube. Everyone has a right to know, even in Catanduanes, what is happening. Dili lang dito na dito in our area wherein everyone was called, no? Yung mga kabarangayan dito, at least kabalo sila, no? And what are moves as the committee itself, ano yung moves nato? Going back to that question, no? I have filed a resolution. After our hearing, I attended the committee hearing in a public order wherein no less than the chief PNP Bato was present. And I filed a resolution, resolution number 899, I'm not sure, no, I have to get back to that. But that resolution states that we as a committee on dangerous drugs should exercise or should act as an oversight committee sa atong bag-o na programa na Tokhang 2 barrel,
double barrel,
reloaded. No? Or, ano, no? But, yes, no? Right now that is also going to be heard in the committee and we will discuss that when we resume. No? So that's how active the Committee on Dangerous Drugs is. Going back to that question, it is not, well, I'm not single outing our province, so this is not political in any way. Because, like I said, I don't want to end my term without doing anything. Ako, nalipay ko that I have done my part as a statesman also, no? Kaya I also not only represent our province, but I also represent the whole Congress, no? Or Congress itself, no?
Okay, you've made mention during kay nakamonitor man ta dito sa congressional inquiry yun nga. Si Congressman Isagani Amatong present dito and Congresswoman Glona Labad-Labad, imo tong gi-refer nga wa gani sila naka-istorya, wala sila mo istorya about that case. Pero on the other hand, nakapunta na po ko anak ni Congresswoman Glona Labad-Labad 2 weeks ago nga nagkita ni sa Ariana Hotel kauban ni Beth Lagaga sa GCP. I asked her that question. Ang ingon niya, wala man daw po sila katungod nga mangutana because di man sila membro sa committee ba?
No, that's not true. That's not true. You can ang role sa house, you can attend and you can ask, but when it comes to voting, if you're not a member, you cannot form part of voting, no? But for you as a member of Congress, obviously, katulad mo to, as a congressman, considering that these things have happened in your district and not mine, no? I give respect to Tita Glona and of course our congressman Amatong. He was there, no? And in fairness, he was looking into the documents that I carried and I gave it openly to him for him to also review, no?
Kailangan nga observers lang sila, sir. Naging sila yung authority to speak
of
out.
Of course. Being a congressman, of course. This is our... The rules in the house says that only...
Ano naging klaro kayo? Huwag mo takipagod kung sa'yo mga procedures,
yes,
no? Inyo ang policy.
Basin, no? In respect to Tita Glona, no? Kaya siguro akala niya, being a first-termer, no? Maybe she thought na dili pwede. Yeah. But of course, it's your right to speak. You just cannot vote. So when it comes to decision making, pag nag-split ang let's say ang committee, ang mga congressmen, no, to for a vote, dili sila pwede. But they can speak, obviously, of course.
Okay.
Of course, lalo na sila, they should. Okay. They should.
So sa the procedure during the hearing, sir, is it regular? Is it normal na kanang kung sila pa tanang ma-raton ba ang mga witnesses ba kay the mode of asking questions mura kuno og kanana ang pan ba adversarial o intimidating?
Well,
ana mo ba na siya usual?
Well, first of all,
no, house inquiry?
Nasanay ang mga congressman when it comes to not deliberating on the budget, no? When we ask questions sa mga ahensya, inana, because we have to ensure that the budget is needed, no? Kana even the mga secretaries, that's how they are when they are subjected to budget hearing. Inana mong good, no? Obviously, because we are not playing here, it's a serious thing. We are spending billions of people's money, so we have to ensure dili pwede humok, no? And it's not our fault that we sounded a little bit adversary or aggressive, wherein because mainly because these people weren't answering the answers to our questions, no? Inana, dili ba ka masukuan na if ang tubag lang is I don't know when it's your job, di ba? Dili ba ka masukuan na if tawa-tawa lang ka, like everything was a joke, like you were untouchable.
Yeah, kay dito good kato si Congressman Tindes. Eh siya na,
is a character.
Kay nagluspad ka.
Oh, is a character, no? Inana ma'am, good ang personality niya.
Ang line of questioning ba? Magkaratul-ratul ba ko po? Basta ako siguro si Pato dito, makapangurus na ko yung kapila o mga jing kay pinakamahal.
I cannot answer. I cannot answer to him, no? But syempre, inana man na, that's how he asks, so... You know, but I just wanted to be objective, no? Yeah. So, kanang mga pangutana na mo, I think it was valid. Those are all valid questions, which weren't addressed before, and it wasn't answered, no? We are not satisfied, and it's unacceptable, yung mga tubag nila. Just the very fact that, going back to the hearing, I don't know if you watched, no? Pero during the time where we were questioning, kinsa to? Yung chief of police dito sa una?
Si Hachuela?
Hachuela. We were questioning him. And he was counter examining our witness, I guess. Si Viola, who was his direct subordinate at that time. He cannot tell me, and it's unacceptable for him to say that he didn't know anything. That's what I'm trying to get at, eh. You know, people, dagaman na minaw, dagaman na tanaw karon. Is that acceptable? You're the chief of police, no? And that's why we're pushing that bill. No, when we pass that bill, you not only are not going to be, you will be accountable for not knowing, no? For not knowing anything. Nga, no, ikaw yung chief of police, ikaw yung provincial director, you didn't know? Napagalaw ni Viola yung SWAT? And then going back to everything, which I asked very clearly, ganito na lang, is it right, tama o mali? Yung ginawa ni Viola, him a police officer doing his job, arresting a drug pusher, the subject niya to blatter, is it right or wrong? Let's go back to morals here and kanang ano ninyo, responsibility as a member of the institution, no?
Okay, there's a text question here, sir, nga, to relay this to you, no, nga, andaw, kananaang, why not bring the issue to the proper authorities like the PDEA, PNP, NBI, or NAPULCOM for that matter? Why bring the issue to the Congress and the media?
The media is only a byproduct of the hearing. No, I didn't mean to bring the issue to the media. But, appeal ka na. No, una-una, that's our job. You cannot question. They must not know what our job is. Come on, ang legislative inquiry. You know, this is why we have that. And that's also our... we are mandated to conduct inquiries wherein agencies that we give or pass budget to are non-performing. Obviously, sayang. Like I said, we're going back to the budget. No, sayang ang kwarta sa atong mga tao, the taxpayers' money, if we don't even use it, no, kung non-performing. So we have the right to conduct legislative inquiries to investigate kung you're doing your job or not. If not, then we will create a legislation to help na dili na mahitabo yung mga nahitabo. If there are lapses, no, in the agencies or the government itself, it's our responsibility and our job as a congressman to create or enact a law to help and assist.
Okay. Sir, napag-ipangutana, ethical or not, no? Pero this is a valid question also. Ang pag-air... Habit ito time. Pero na, hostage ka na mo. Kining pag-live sa News Radio Dapitan City, sa Radyo Bibo, sa the entire proceedings, no? Sa House Inquiry for two times, the live na siya on air. So, ningan sila, o dili politika, nga nang tuwa man dito sa lain na kuan ko no, nga istasyon, gilive ko no, amot lang, o, gibayaran ba din on sa, pero this is a valid question.
Okay, can I answer the valid question? Yes. First of all, during the first hearing, they were there. In fact, five of the media, I don't know. Well, pa ilan,
pero
I don't know eh, but they were there. They were there. They signed, they were there. They were inside the room. It's not my fault na dili nila gilive. At gilive nito. And number two, this is public, it's our sole duty to the public. No, it's a public hearing. Why is it our fault? Or nga no, mali na ilive something like that? People have the right to know. And it's your duty as a radio commentator or announcer or whatever to air it out because it's public hearing. No, it is not a court. Again, no, they are interested to see what's happening in our very own province. So, ako, I salute the radio stations that aired it. Ang pangutana, why didn't you air it? Your announcers were there, present. Kato, let me go back, bring that question back to them. Oh, kung dili political, ngano dili nyo gi-air? What's barring you from airing it? Did I stop you from airing it? I think everyone should have the right to know, no? Right of information. Ano wala nang i-air? Mao nang gi-post nato sa Facebook, gi-post nato sa YouTube. So everyone, whether political ally, color or what, can decide for themselves, no? The hearings were very clear. There was no politic in there. We didn't abuse our authority. I did not bully anyone. I may have gotten disappointed at one point kung dili matubag yung mga pangutana namo, but I am doing my job as a congressman to also ensure that these questions are answered directly, considering they were allegations, no? Them involving these police officers as part of the drug and the killings here in the province, no? So we gave them the platform to air out and to defend themselves, which they did not. Mo nang porque wala nila natupag, political na. How convenient naman, no? I think that's very unfair for the congressman. Mo nang during the first hearing, if you notice, I wasn't even talking. And if ito I'm not controlling the hearings, no. If ever the chairman wishes to call the governor, right now I will tell you. Dili ko mo question. I'm not gonna be there just to give a little bit of delicadeza or
mainhibit ka.
Ako mismo mag-inhibit ko. So as for the committee to conduct to work as a committee and not as me attacking, no, the governor. I don't want that to happen. You know, like I said, my intention was not to character assassinate anyone. Our intention is to give justice where, or kung i-air out or expose ka ng mga ahensya na may mga lacking, no? I say it again, if the chairman, no, Chairman Ace Barbers, requests for another hearing and these personalities be called, I will inhibit myself for further questioning, no? As a delicadeza or a parliamentary or a courtesy to our governor and the mayor or the people in the province.
So, all things considered, are you satisfied with what you have accomplished from your privileged speech up to the to congressional inquiry? Okay ra?
No, no, wala pa yung resulta. So, I'm not satisfied. If you're gonna ask me now kung I am satisfied, of course I'm not. What has happened? Nothing has happened. We just made a little bit of noise, but that's it. Like you, I'm also looking for answers. I'm also looking for a substantial result as to the hearings, as to what is happening. And gusto ko makita sa atong probinsya mismo. I want the police to be more snappier, and I want them to see na dili pwede yung mga inana-inana na just because you ordered or whatever things, you know, if it's illegal, whatever, dili pwede inana, no? Someone should be accountable to what has happened, no?
Okay. Ngayon magkaroon, sir, no, with your respect, na panalitan, mo decide ang chairman si Congressman Ace Barbers, may tatawag silang governor, mo inhibit ka for delicadeza and all those, no? Naipangutan na gihapon diri nga panalitan na dito si tatawag panalitan yun silang governor, kuan, kanana ang dili ba mahulog ni siya nga trial by publicity nga naruin ang reputation nilang governor because of these inquiries, and then only later on as a result walay unsa na
marag, you know,
dili satis fight kaayo mo sa nangitabo.
That's exactly my point, Ma'am Edith, no, when we started, going back to this political thing. Again, I did not mention the names of the governor or the Puy family. I did not even call them during our first hearing because if my intention was to character assassinate them by trial, by publicity, I would have requested for them, since we control the House, for them to be present during the first and second hearing. And that is the reason why I've answered also a while ago that I will inhibit myself if ever the chairman wishes to call the governor to avoid nga trial by publicity. That's my point. No? So, kanang mga nag-text sa atin, thank you for your queries, no? But I assure you, this is not in any way an intention to ruin the trust and confidence of our governor. It is for him to make a move already and for him to see, oh, what's been happening. Kana, ikaw man nag-appoint sa imong provincial director. Ikaw mga tana, no? Mga tana nyo kung why these things are still happening in broad daylight. And why? Ito pinaka-question na ko. Since our hearing in November, why hasn't there had any controversial killings na inana since then to now? There was a drastic drop in crime ever since. Now you ask me why.
Why?
Exactly. Why? Because I think the police are now more aware and they are doing their jobs. And they know that people, they're answerable to the people, not just the governor. Let me ask the provincial director, why during his interview sinabi ni governor na ito anghel na ko si P.D. Wagan? Why is that?
Sinong nagsabi, sir?
Again, it's public document. In an interview, if you want, we can pull that out somewhere. He answered, he said, the governor said, the provincial director is his angel. I don't know why. Muna ako, mamutan ako. Bakit siya anghel? Why is he an angel? As to what? For what? Diba?
Okay, last question ha, Congressman.
Yes, please.
Yes, okay. Finally. all things has been done and said and done, no? Do na ba dyan kay kaligot-got deep in your heart? Kasabot ko sa kaligot-got? Kanabang yung kasakit, kasukot
yes, yes,
deep
yes.
In your heart? O sa any mga tao dito sa Sambuaga del Norte, especially the governor and his family,
no.
And also Maklang, kay special mention man sige, muna nga nahitabo ning tanan.
Okay, first of all, to get this out of the ano no, out of the my chest, no, una I have none. In fact, I've always commended Governor Berto and even Pimpin is a friend of mine. No, muna ako mismo nasakitan sa video na gipakita. No, I will not mention anymore whatever it is, no. Pero he's a friend of mine and I don't want to put people in places where they shouldn't be. No? So I have taken I let the case take its course and ang ako in regards to Maklang, ang kasakit lang ako is yung sistema, not him as a person. That's why I apologize. No, I apologize to him. Whether if I flared up a bit during that time, sabi ko it's a very personal. I'm sorry if I'm a little emotional. But things have happened during your watch. With up to now, I have questioned even your promotion as a colonel during that time, considering all the human rights violations that you've done to our people. When I say our people, atong kababayan, kay ngano, taga-dari ba siya? For him to abuse our people here na gisapak niya, gitira niya, gitreten niya. And now, since it has already come out, because these people, sila Daligdig Brothers, are under Maklang. So, karon nanigawas na na si Maklang mismo, allegedly, by these witnesses, was the mastermind, no? On everything, sambot naman sa kuko. Kaya nga, no, what gives you the right to do that to our people? You're not from here, di ba?
Kay Governor Roberto Uy and family, kay close friends man inyong mga family, di ba?
Correct, yeah, that's why I repeat myself. I have nothing against them, no? I have not even mentioned his name in the hearing. Ang nag-mention sa Uy family was the general, sila PD, sila, and the witnesses. Ako, even if you look at the minutes, no, review it, I didn't mention it, if not mentioned by the Daligdig Brothers. No? So let me make that clear. Again, everything is documented, public knowledge, and the information readily at hand. You can look at YouTube, you can look at whatever kanang just go back to the hearings and kayo maghusga mismo and then you tell me what you think, you know, na mo'y freedom of ano to for your freedom for your own opinions and I'm telling you that I'm just doing my job. I'm sorry if you feel like I'm attacking you. Let me make that clear. I am not in any intention, any way, to as character assassinate or publicly shame these people. Mao nang si Albuar nakaingon, no, na nasakitan siya, nagitawag siya. I question him again. Why? Didn't you call? Are you denying that you called Taligdig after the murder? He did not deny that. So obviously, he should be called. Because of that. And then now he's saying sa Ilahang station that this person is alive. The question was not whether he is alive or dead. Dili ni Las Cañas case, no? He cannot do that and discredit the witness himself in fairness to the witness. He cannot do that. Okay? First of all, what his statement said was he was involved in these killings and in these shootings. Whether or not the person died, the crime was still committed. No? So kung buhi siya, then good. I'm happy, mas maayo, no? At least wala siya napuruhan. But based on the statements of the Ligbig, they said they shot him. Katulad yung basis na ako eh. Was the statements, I'm not making anything up. So I'm sorry, no, Edgar Fons, no, I have to go. Dagang salamat.
Parting words and statements.
Okay, dagang salamat, no, sa pag-imbita na ako, no, sa Katiyan. I love coming here.
Sa sunod, yun na magdali, ha?
What 2 hours ba yan? No? No, but yes, actually I just want to spend my time while I'm here, no, to go around and to take time to go around my mga barangays because I'm sure they also miss me. No? Sa next issue niya. Next na lang, ha? Medyo mataas na po. No, but yes, I'd like to say thank you, no, this opportunity sa mga atong mga supporters, no, na nitabang nako. To put me again in position for my last term, and I assure you, I promise you, na tanang mga proyekto na gisugdan ako, humanon gid nato, no? So kanang mga kalye, pasensya na kung ginagawa. I am just DPWH is doing their job, and your taxpayers' money is working for you, no? So again, salamat sa atong mga announcers diri sa Kapian sa Dipolog, and thank you. And next time, siguro I can take time to answer
promise,
more questions. Ha? Promise. Thank you so much, Mayim.
Okay, thank you so much, Congressman Secretary T. Halusos, no, for your time. Sa ulitin, sir, ha? Okay, so thank you so much, sir. God bless you. Okay, balik ka rin, ha? Promise. Okay, thank you so much, no. So, gagaling yung kayo si Congressman Seth Frederick Dolit Halusos. Ato yung kalipay nga, ato siyang gikauban karumutaga, kay daghan kayong gaatan, saya ang pag-ani sa Kapihan sa Dipolog. Siguro satisfied po ang atong naminaw, ato ang mga viewers sa atong live streaming, kay murag mga difficult questions sa magibuto, no? Ang ato ang na pangutana niya, no? Dili gito ingon nga scripted nga questions kay ato mga ning gi-open
interview.
Yes. Ato mga ning gi-open ang ato anong program para sa uban nga gusto pod mo inquire, no? Mo ask questions sa iya about the congressional inquiry. So atong murag i-summarize gamay, no? Pons, i-recap na to gamay. Unsay giingon ni Congressman Dolit Halusos? Wala siyay ansa to? Wala siya intention nga ma-damage sa Boga del Norte. Naa? Okay? And then, on sa to, wala siya personal nga grudges? O, kaaligot?
In fact, suod ng ilang pamilya, and one of them is suod pagid niya nga amigo personal. Wala yung ipag-ingon.
Ngayon, nga nung wala gi-air sa ubang radio station niya, gi-air dito sa Radyo Vivo. Wala man kuno siya, wala daw niya pugsa, no?
Wala niya pugsa, kinsay mo air. Kinsay mo air.
Sa mga media. Okay.
Nga maraga ang iyong ipagawas nga. Ang iyong ibarugan nga, prerogative sa mga
kompanya o station.
Particular radio station, kung ilang i-air night o din ang mga proceedings. Kaya ang nahimu pong bukan sa banyan ng all of all the radio stations nga nung ang Radyo Vivo lang ang ga-air live.
Okay, so doon naman tayo nang i-comments, no? You go over lang sa ato ang Kapihan sa Dipolog account sa atong YouTube na aman diha kay si Silbert ya man ning upload ayon no. So you just go over our Kapihan sa Dipolog edition, dito ninyo makuha kanan no state diri sa tong Kapihan sa Dipolog kay kabalo man ta nga daghan pa unta tay pangutana pero we are running out of time, then busy po kayo.
I am very particular kung sa iyang mahuna-hunaan nga balaon na niya iluso sa Kongreso.
Yes,
so, kung nahisgot pang rin sa mga lapses. Sa ito, pag kung doon ang mga lapses, aron mahimo mo na yung maunda nun, ipaagin na sa legislation para mahimong tamdanan sa uban.
In aid of legislation, hinapunta nga, na, marisulta, Job, maningil taan na po niya. O, kumusta na human sa congressional inquiry niya nga ukyab ang tanan sa Sabuaga del Norte here and abroad? Unsa may nahitabo? Naabay resulta sa himo nga congressional inquiry? Dili ba to nga puros lang kung batod pa nila puros lang to siya publicity stunt?
Mao lagi alam mo niya diay last corner siya as congressman dayon ang impression is he's planning to run for some other government position.
Local.
Most probably, maraga yung lang yung target is governor. Pero ila po na huna-huna, o ila po na ang pagtuo ng mga ilakang sa kongresista, apan sumala siya ang ipamahit, iyang ipabarugan, as of now, wala pa yun siya yung huna ng plano o unsamang position ang iyang daganan. Kaya ang niyang sumala sa iyong pahayag sa pagkakaroon, iya pa unang gihuna-huna kung unsay ang kaayuhan niya ikadulot sa mga tao na nagpuyo sa distrito ng iyong servisyo.
Yes, and speaking of EJK, ato matang i-point out na o niingon siya na mo na yung hitabo doon ng mga patay under the protection of the police, PDIA, o uban pang mga authorities, does it mean to say na naputay EJK this province of Sabuaga del Norte? Pero iya mag-ingon na rub out daw to.
Oh, gani, it's only now nga akong atong nasayran niya, doon na daw pastoral letter.
Oo.
Na ni...
Kinsa nga, Bishop?
German.
Silbert, ha?
German.
Ah, okay.
Dugay naman to?
Dugay na. Bishop kay Ermari nga, pastoral letter, ibasa?
Dugay naman to?
Ah, dugay na, okay.
Durag wala nila kalimti, wang balik.
Ah, okay. So, tinood nga na yung pastoral letter. Ato lang, to make sure lang ba, to be
before
factual.
Okay.
Bishop Kair Maring, before pa sa congressional inquiry, before pa nila maralo guban pa.
Okay.
Ato lang nang iklaro ba, kay, di, wala man na tanag take sides doon, kay neutral man ta diri ang objective.
Wala na yung ipagawas na itong bisita, yung mga yung pamahayag kanina, out sa itong mga pangutana. Kung sabi itong di-reiterate na ito, Derek.
Okay. We're not taking sides sa itong motor. We're not taking sides. But we are only...
Atong our program sa public affairs program. So atong di-buno sa itong mga listeners, apag timbang-timbang. Sila rin magtibang-timbang.
Ang atong mga atong ipasagdahan ng pasibaw sa ilang baruganan, o atong hatagan o katumudan atong mga suking tagpaminaw, atong mga bureau sa Kapihan sa Dipolog, na mutimbang-timbang. So, ang sa ilang nadonggan locally, o sa donggan nila sa pamahayag katong kongresista karong buntaga, o sila na ibahala. So, mama na yung i-reiterate nga, kamo na ibahalan mutimbang-timbang kung asa mo mo to sa ato, sa inyo bang nadonggan karon o sa unsa inyong nadonggan dyan sa kalye.
And anyways, dili po ta angay dili mo apologize to anybody. Wala man.
You have nothing to apologize.
Si, wa man god, hita mo man god.
You are just bringing the messenger here.
Okay, nago di po siya.
The messenger.
Nago di po siya po, nyo taga din sa Bonga del Norte. So, kinsa man, alalang mo invite ato bang kumisista dito ng at pang year. Kailangan man siya dito, nga kung naa sa grupo. So, siya mo pinaka atong na-invite niya rin para in fact nakita naman po niya kailan din natin buka ang dagan na nakita
niya. Mag-expect naman po ito nga ugma labi na kay Lunes posibleng ay mga reaction ng atong paminaw libre po mo inyo po ng opinion.
I-acknowledge lang ang Kapihan sa Dipolog ha, ang voice clip ninyo.
Tibutan lang po, courtesy, pam.
Tugol man sa iyong pamatasan, di ba?
Yes.
Tabalo man ta.
Yes, ala ginagawa na yun.
Hindi man ta na nato ma-accommodate.
Marunong ito. Kaya na nag-consulta.
Responsible media men, no? So, like, for us, ato may acknowledge this sa tagika, nasa anana. So, ato may na-quote, no? So, ana na po na itong hangyo. So, whatever, doon ang mga violent reactions, gikan rin sa tungod sa kapiyan sa Dipolo nga atong interview with Congressman Boli Talasos karon o mapuhon, Congressman, oh. Ibo na dahil ang kahanginan.
Gani malay.
Nakalig sa ko ng kapiyan sa Dipolo.
Gani malay ako
nakita. Gamito ninyo ang among interview.
Gani malay ako nakita ni other gawas ni Congressman Talasos. At sa pagpun, tingali, one of these days, mabisita sad nato si Congressman Glona, no? Okay? Ah, dito good siya, good po. Oh. Wala siya nakapangutana.
Actually, ako na nag-invite si Congressman, Congresswoman Glona 2 weeks ago. Pero yun siya nga, isip pa daw siya, dito siya. Pangita na siya time.
Yes, na, that's good, yun. Nag-hand po siya mga projecting yung pangasal. Siya mismo, sa wala siya nakapangutana, pwede siya siya, nakita siya, kaya dito man siya. Pwede siya nakuha dito. Kasi mo naman tasugit sa unsa yung nakita dito sa
kumpisyon.
Sa kumpisyon. O sa kumpisyon.
Yan sa gabi naman. Siri-siri po na kumpisyon.
Mao na nga. Pero yung acknowledgement sila officially. Nga present sila dito. So, atong, ato lang i-share no nga. Maybe next week, April 2, kay coming man ang dili, Holy Week ka na State of the Province address ni Governor Roberto Uy. So maybe ang mga trusted lieutenants po ni Governor Roberto Uy atong ma-invite diri karong Domingo pohon in preparation sa State of the Province address, mahisgutan po nato kung sa po ilang take, ilang opinion bayan sa atong interview ni Congressman Boli Talasos, especially si ano former Consihal Proxy Rubia nga maoy manager sa Provincial Information Center karong panahon na at the same time executive assistant for sa Office of the Provincial Governor, and maybe we can also invite for the second time, kaya man nakatunga dire, si Provincial Administrator, Bernard, Joey Bernard, no? And then, siguro, ugma po, makita mo dito sa session ni board member Julius Napikit, kaya na-privilege speechman siya po, ana, ito man ang question, ganina ang kuan, ano, bahin sa Sambunga del Norte, o si Vice Governor Senen Alvis Angeles mismo, no? Atong dalon ris kanginan karong Domingo para mahisgutan nato unsa gyud kaayo ang angay nato as a people, no? Ang angay natong buhaton nga mag-go forward ta sa Sambunga del Norte kay labi na diha sa Facebook daghan kay manggiaway diha mahig politika na unsa ang Sambunga del Norte kay isimauna ngano man dayo kanang dili day pwede nga ang black ug ang white will go together. No? Di ba?
Kabang mo ko na tawagan na huwag magkuyog ng black and white.
Kulo na may lawa. Ano sa lang ito mo? Manatangan?
Angay po nila itong malakit sa itong pagpamalandong. Ilabi na nga sa liabot ng Sinama Santa.
Yes.
At least mahuna, malantaw na ito ang atong mahimong papel sa atong katilingban. Nining atong pag sa ulo sa Sinama Santa.
Okay. April 4 man po, April 2, 3, 4, numero 4 po ang ka-Mayor Daryl Uy na State of the City address.
April 4.
Yes, ang kang-Mayor Nini Halosos, March 31, sa Dapitan City, ang State of the City address po to. Muna to ingon nilang hope o ni Consihal Alimarlo Dati, no? Si Wilbert Magallanes ilang City Administrator o si Apple Marie Agulong ang ilang City Tourism Officer. Invited man gihapon ganito sa kapihan sa Dipolo. Okay, sa asa manggutang
huwag niya pa manapit sa 3rd District at 2 board.
Maon dyan. Ato lang ipakita na neutral ta. No? Objective.
Ngayon naman ito rin naman ka. Wala
premira.
Okay. So, pila na minutes na to. Ato na lang ipahimusan ang nabilin ng higayon kay huwag pa to gadaling si Congressman Burit. Daghan pa dito ang ipangutana atong tua. So, 9 minutes more to go before we wind up our program. No? Karong March 26 na edition sa itong kapihan sa Dipolo. Gar?
Yes. Yes, of course. May balota. Daghang nagpaminaw niya ito. So, once again, daghang tanaw, daghang review niya ito. We will urge you to review, no? Katong mga nasa live streaming, katong maka-retrieve ato sa YouTube, i-review ninyo. Matimbang-timbang ninyo, not only nga nagdungog ninyo karon, i-review ninyo para makita, may bawaan ninyo, good of
kamu yung makatibak-tibang mismo. No? Kaya mo mo this to bring them para maibawaan ninyo. Out, sila pa out of the horse's mouth. No? Kaya sila good. Dahil tagig na mag-istorya. So, review niyo sa YouTube para makita ninyo ang maong edisyon. No? Kay Baloning, nagagyan kayo. Around po, makatibak po mo, mga pangutalan sa mga sakos pamilya, yung mga nakita po mo o nakadungo po mo, nararap mo na
ispagyo. Wala ganito kapangutan na bayan sa Nautical Highway.
Ako, yes.
Nagyari na rin ni Congressman Natalion Alvarez.
Maunan talagang pumunta mo na.
Kaya agi itong tuang sa tuang ko.
Nakakuan mo daw si Kuno siya. Commit na siya dito. In fact, kuan pa, an hour ago pa. Pero yan, hindi akong gistin ganito dali, no? An hour ago pa siya na-commit dito. Pero okay lang, ha? Almost mapunta mo man. Isa nakabuhi, huwag magiging buhi. Tama din na matubag ko niya
mga pangkakaroon.
Wala din po yung dilibog daw. Wala din po yung
dilibog daw. Unara pa siya dali, no? Wala pa silang taxi, silver, wala pa mga duha. Kay mga late covers man. Pag-abot na ko dali, pagkataon-taon, naabot na yun siya. Sa hindi na kayo siya matubag sa pangutana.
Much more, og mahuman na po kung mahuman ng proseso. Ako na siya paninyan, kung saman karoon nga, kung manaman.
Importante na, updating.
Updating.
Panil nga na to siya, unsay nahitabo. Kung sa iyang privilege speeches, iyang congressional
inquiry. Kaya man kung gibulado mo eh.
So,
inanglan mo, nag-end result.
Nag-end result na yun. Is it positive? Will it help the people of Zamboanga del Norte? Will it help the province to move forward?
Change for the better.
Muna ang gingon. So, dili yun nga, basta lang nga, matunong pons, nagbulabog niya, nga muna mo na, kundili, doon ay something good out of it.
Kaya wala mong gawa, actually, ang epekto sa gihimo ni Congressman Halusos, wala, nakakonfine lang din niya sa ato. Kaya daghan na biya, kaya kahit sa unang tuwa sa gawas, unya, kompleto na po mga bagong gadget, nga, natigaw na daw niya, unsa nga nabiyayin mo diha, nga naabot mo din rin ang alingas-ngas ninyo. Munang nasug na ngayon, anay naman eh, manghinauta na makaangko ni og positibong kalambuan og madamlag kaninya ang maong panghitabo karon. We are not up against anybody sa ato nang ingon. Ang ato lang is mapalanog na to, mapabot na to ang mga impormasyon nga dapat gikan sa right person and authority nga mo'y gikanan na ni kay dili kay kita mismo muhin mo mo kay wala tay direct knowledge yun sa mga panghitabo kung kuan pa.
So, kung sa ipanulti nila pikas-pikas, we'll rely on their statements alone. It's up to us to weigh things over.
Okay. Oh, magandang nga. Ako, napagpahinan nga. Kala ako nga palusod na alit, so di pa na po malibot. Ngayon, ito na ako na ka-exunan sa San Vicente, sa San Vicente Ferrer Chapel sa Minaho, kay kaganihan din, tag, among gidawat si ang Divine Mercy gikan sa Santo Niño sa Tambak. Among gidawat alas kwarto ang takna sa kadlawon dahil gipigayon ang misa ni Father Amel Krong dayon karon alauna gikan sa among kapilya sa San Vicente Ferrer amok na pud ni siya ihatod nga to sa St. Joseph the Spouse of Mary dahil sa may old airport drive amok na siya ihatod sa itong hangyong itong mga kaigsunan dahil sa nga sakop sa kapilya sa San Vicente nga itong hugupan ang paghatod ni Mama Mary ang Divine Mercy nga ito sa sunod niya kapilya para adto na din ito dihatod dito yung sa parokya na mismo sa Sintianon.
Okay, belated happy birthday nga ito kang Leonardo Nonoy Sasil, nga ito kang Kate Sandra Pahinti Sasil, belated happy birthday niyo. Belated happy birthday nga ito kang Mary Ann Pahinti nga ito sa Dubai karong panahon na. So, thank you sa kainan agabi. Salamat kayo. And God bless you all.
Okay, so, Balay?
Yes, wala natin panahon. Mangayon lang tayo parting words and statements gikan sa atong mga panelists kung butang na dili na guest.
Okay, but lang sa itong masukin ko ng now. The seniority nini.
Ikaw na lahat. Ito na lahat.
Wala sa sirma ito. Ay, di ka dyan.
Ipuli mo ka. Ipuli mo ka. Ipuli mo
ka. Atong kauban si Sir Julius in town. Kumusta?
Oh, okay. Julius.
Mga na ito na
Saking lihok na yung pickers flowers deh, kalau orang nak lihok. Ugin na utang sa makaangkun ka sa hipit niya kay Johan Mikan sa imo nga sinatiyan karong mga adlaw. O sa atong mga sulking tiktok na ugod, happy birthday kay Dudong Ingrito kagahapon. Naman niya dito sa mga renewal, nadiritso niya sa iyang celebration. Belated happy birthday daw, mong kaawan usap sa kabag. O sa atong mga sulking tiktok na tanan niya nagkaminaw, o tanan niya nagyos ang kapihan sa dipolog, main lumbay.
Okay, ako na i-greet si Manuel Magallanes Pahinti, silang Everglass, silang Vicky, sa Mutia. Kusog kayo atong signal dito, Kapadilumi, Pulangko, Pinyan, Mutia. Kusog kayo, loud and clear, matong i-text ko ninyo agabi. Mga alas 9 na to sa gabi. So, maing buntag, maing pagpaminaw dia sa lungsod sa Mutia, lungsod sa Pinyan, lungsod sa Pulangko, ikan sa Kapihan, sa Dipolog. Edgar?
Okay, so dili kay salamat sa mga sugid ti paminaw nga sa kanunay nag monitor sa tong palibog sa tong mga kapihan sa Dipolo. Kamo lang ipanginaot nga unta nakakuha kamo og mga impormasyon og mga gusto niyo mahibaw-an sa matag semana, matag Domingo nga kami nagpahigayon sa kapihan sa Dipolo. Kay mo na among tahas diri ang pagatod kaninyo kung sa man ang pag ang gusto niyo mahibaw-an pa-out sa mga issues nga misolbon din sa atong lalawigan ng Duha Kadakbayan. So thank you very much. Happy Sunday.
Thank you so much. Then ako na-greet lang Elmas, lang Marlo, lang Arjun, lang Ardi, si Lady. Anamira ay karon.
Bumuti sa tinuot po ng Alimalo.
Konsyal, Alimalo, that we do happy birthday. Ngayon, magang salamat na to kang Silbert, Abiyati Kodondriano, nga mawain nagdala sa itong live streaming www.rmninfolog.weebly.com o ingon man uploaded kita sa YouTube, click lang ang YouTube Kapihan sa Dipolo sa YouTube matag semana. Labi na karon ga expected daghang viewers karon sa atong Kapihan sa Dipolo tungod sa atong bisita nga si Congressman Seth Frederick Bullet Halosos. And of course, thank you so much simultaneous broadcast si Pinaagi kang Tax Ilumba sa RMN DXDR 981 AM o ingon man sa 94.1 IFM. Dayon dito sa istasyon, daghang kay salamat sa atong RMN Broadcast Center. To adito si Danny Luot, si Roger Manira, si Mardi Libre, si Elaine. Sa ngalan sa atong station manager na si Mr. Edgar Dagumo. To Gabriel the Glory, kini si Edwin Pahinti Tumang, inyong regular anchor and host sa Kapihan sa Dipolog. Mingan kalinyo, happy Sunday. God bless us all. Studio, take it away.